Welcome to Math Contest Drills for Filipino Kids videos. This time, let us again relive the Grade 6 MMC National Finals in 2015 Average Round. In the Average Round, participants are allowed to use scratch paper and each item must be answered in 30 seconds. Final answer must be written on an answer sheet before the time expires. Okay, before we continue, please subscribe for more Math Contest Drills for Filipino Kids videos. Question number 1. 1,600 equals 5 squared times A raised to B. What is the biggest possible value of B if A and B are both whole numbers? Again, 1,600 equals 5 squared times A raised to B. What is the biggest possible value of B if A and B are both whole numbers? Go. Time is up. The answer is 6. Question number 2. The midpoints of consecutive sides of a 4 cm by 6 cm rectangle are joined together so that 4 triangles are formed. The total area of the 4 triangles represent how many percent of the area of the rectangle? Again, the midpoints of consecutive sides of a 4 cm by 6 cm rectangle are joined together so that 4 triangles are formed. The total area of the 4 triangles represent how many percent of the area of the rectangle? Go. Time is up. The answer is 50%. Next, question number 3. Observe the pattern below. 2, 5, 10, 17, 26, and so on. If 122 is the nth number in the pattern, what is n? Again, observe the pattern below. 2, 5, 10, 17, 26, and so on. If 122 is the nth number in the pattern, what is n? Go. Number 5, 33⅓% of 547.5 is 50% of what number? Again, 33⅓% of 547.5 is 50% of what number? Go. Time is up. What is the answer? It's 365. Did you get all five? Okay, at this point, let us discuss the answers to the 30-second questions. Number one, 1,600 equals 5 squared times a raised to b. We know that 1,600 can be factored 25 times 64. And 5 squared is 25, so dividing both sides by 25, we get 64 equals a raised to b. And 64 as an exponential expression can be written as 8 squared, 4 cubed, or 2 raised to 6. So the biggest value possible for b is when 64 is written as 2 raised to 6, where a is 2 and b is 6. Question number 2. Let us have the figure for this problem. So we have a rectangle. Midpoints of consecutive sides are connected, forming four triangles. So if the rectangle originally measures 4 by 6 centimeters, then we'll have triangles whose legs measure 2 centimeters and 3 centimeters. Because the 6 centimeter side of the rectangle is divided into 3 and 3, while the 4 centimeter side of the rectangle is divided into 2 and 2. So we have four triangles with measures 3 and 2 on its legs. Then the area of the triangle, 4 of them, that will be 4 times the area of the triangle, over the area of the rectangle times 100% will be the percentage of the area of the triangle with respect to the rectangle. So the area of the triangle is 3 times 2 over 2, then that will be 4 times 3 times 2 all over 2, divided by the area of the rectangle, 4 times 6, and that will be 12 over 24 times 100. 12 over 24 is 1/2 or 0.5, then the answer is 50%. Next, question number 3. If we look at the pattern 2, 5, 10, 17, 26, we have differences as 3, 5, 7, and 9. If we continue with this pattern, the differences are in arithmetic progression with common difference 2, then we will have 122 as the 11th term. However, if you observe again at the sequence or the numbers 2, 5, 10, 17, 26, these are numbers that are one more than the consecutive perfect squares. So that's 1 squared plus 1, 2. 2 squared plus 1, 5, 3 squared plus 1, 10, 4 squared plus 1, 17, and 5 squared plus 1, 26. Therefore, this pattern has the formula n squared plus 1. Then we have n squared plus 1 equals 122, so n squared equals 121. Square root of both sides, we have n equals 11. Next, question number 4. So we have the ratio 1 to 4 to 9 for 3 cylinders having a common height. Let H be that common height. D be the area of the base of cylinder D, and F be the area of the base of cylinder F, then we have the ratio 1 to 4 to 9, and then D, E, and F will have DH, area of the base of D times H will be its volume. The same with F, area of the base F times H will be its volume. Now, applying the cross product property of proportion, we will get D as equal to 9 pi square centimeters, and F equals 81 pi square centimeters. So the difference is 72 pi square centimeters. Next, number 5. 33 1/3% is 1/3. So let N be that number missing. Then we'll have 1/3 of 547.5, and this is equivalent to 50% of N. 50% is 1/2. So N equals 2 times 1/3 of 547.5. 547.5 times 1/3 is 182.5. Multiply this by 2, therefore N is 365. That is all. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe for more math contest drills for Filipino kids videos.